Hey, what's up YouTube? This is Phil Ebner with VideoSchoolOnline.com bringing you another tutorial on exporting from Adobe Premiere Pro. This time specifically talking about what is my favorite fast, quick, and small file size export to use when exporting videos, especially for like rough cuts, you know, if you want to send to a client or, you know, whoever your video partner is and you want to show them a rough cut before you export the final full HD version. You know, you don't want to be sitting, you know, waiting 20, 30 minutes or even up to a few hours for longer videos for it to export and then upload. So this is my favorite export settings for small size and quick export time. So say you have your project, I'm working on this how to build an online teaching career course. You can check it out at onlineteachingcareer.com to learn more about it. So that's my plug. But go up to export media or just press Command M or Control M if you're on a PC. Format, make sure that you know it's under H.264, which is a QuickTime format, really small files compared to the quality of the video. Preset, I want you to go down to, I choose Vimeo SD widescreen 23976. So this is, you know, 16:9 format. It's SD, so it's not HD quality. But if you're using YouTube, you can probably use one of these settings, but even the Vimeo setting will work fine. So you can see here, this is the size of it, 640 by 360. And then you go down to bitrate. Change the bitrate encoding from VBR 2-pass to VBR 1-pass. This in itself will cut down the export time in almost a half because 2-pass goes over the video 2 times while exporting so that the quality is really high. VBR 1-pass, you know, it's just a quick export and that's fine. Target bitrate, you can see here, this is what affects the estimated file size. If I decrease target bitrate to 0.5, you know, I don't like going below 0.5, 0.7 is ideal. For a really small size. 200 megabytes is, you know, not small, but for a 30-minute video, that is a really good file size. And then change the maximum bitrate to something like 0.9, just so it's not bouncing up too high to, because this is just an estimate, but that will limit it to 0.9 megabytes per second. And then you just press export and you're done. This will give you a fast export and a small file size. So really the best of both worlds when you are needing to export a rough cut, you know, your first version of a project to get notes on or whatever. All right, thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe, you know, to the Video School Online channel. Write any comments down below if you like the video or if you have any questions. Otherwise, share it with your friends and we'll see you in the next lesson. Bye.